Chelsea news: the truth behind Marcos Alonso's agreed move to Real Madrid as kid. For Alonso is a boyhood Atletico fan. His dad Marcos Alonso Pena played for the club in the late 1980s, while also managing them during the 2001-02 campaign, which ended in a failed promotion from the Segunda Division. Alonso has red and white, yes, he really does, blood running through him. The club is in his DNA. So given his family connection, it'd have been safe to assume Marcos would have joined Atletico after showing promise as a child. After all, the Adarvalvi new team coach Pepe Fernandez had informed Atletico that he was a youngster to watch and the wheels were put in motions to get him to the club. He was the lad, skinny and slight at the time, they wanted, but it wasn't to be. Dad Pena put the stop to any agreement because the club was too far away from his son's school. Instead, Alcobendas, a side based close to the Alonso family home, were the lucky recipient of his services. Not that Marcos was happy. Spanish newspaper Marca claim Alonso wanted to play for Atletico, to formally offer him a place at their academy. Atletico's loss was their archrival's gain. It meant Real Madrid won the race to snap him up, following a season where he scored 25 goals for the Alvinuth side under Fernandez. Although his move to Real frustrated the Alonso family at first, grandfather Mark Guidos, who played for the Bernabe Giants in the 1950s, and son Pena were unhappy that their boy was being used as a winger. They were also disgruntled by a lack of playing time at Real, so Marcos moved back to Alvin for a season, only for him to return a year later. By this point, Fernandez, the man who once recommended him to Atletico, was in charge of Real's youth sides. He took Alonso under his wing and set him on his way for a professional career. He broke into the Real Madrid B side but could never push onto the first team. That prompted the Spaniard to join Bolton in 2010 before spells at Fiorentina and Sunderland. A switch to Chelsea was completed in 2016 and 12 months later he was a champion. Express Sport looks at the Spanish side ahead of their clash with Chelsea in the Champions League. Eagle striker Diego Costa finally has been granted his wish to return to Atletico after 3 years and two Premier League titles with Chelsea. The Brazil-born Spain striker will be reunited with Diego Simeone, the much-admired Atletico boss best remembered by English audiences for being the recipient of David Beckham's petula and kick in England's second-round loss to Argentina at the 1998 World Cup. Simeone has never lost to English opposition as a coach, winning 3 of the 5 contests. Chelsea connection as well as Costa, who will be able to play for Atletico again once their transfer embargo is lifted in January, there are other familiar faces in opposition. Philippe Luis and Fernando Torres, plus Thiago, who is now an assistant coach, all had spells at Stamford Bridge. Belgium goalkeeper Thibaut Courtois spent 3 years on loan at Atletico from Chelsea, winning La Liga in 2013-14. Radamel Falcao, now at Monaco, had a successful spell at Atletico and an underwhelming one at Chelsea. Previous meetings: Chelsea have 1 win in 5 European games against Atletico, the first meeting in October 2009. The sides most recently met in the 2013-14 semi-finals. Courtois was permitted to play under UEFA rules. Goalless after the first leg, Atletico won 3-1 at Stamford Bridge to advance to a Madrid derby in the Lisbon final. Real Madrid won La Decima, their 10th European Cup, after more than a decade of trying. But Atletico had won the league title for the first time in 18 years, breaking the Real Barcelona hegemony. Form: Atletico are unbeaten in 11 games in all competitions, including their final 4 matches of last season. They opened their Champions League campaign with a goalless draw at Roma. Atletico have conceded 1 goal in their last 5 games following last Saturday's 2-0 win over Sevilla at the Metropolitano. Metropolitano Chelsea may be envious of Atletico's modern new home. Los Rojiblancos moved from the fabulous but crumbling Vicente Calderon Stadium this season, playing their first home match at their new ground on September 16, a 1-0 win over Malaga. Chelsea are considering a rebuild of Stamford Bridge and would likely welcome the influx of foreign investment, which has seen Chinese conglomerate want to sponsor the Metro.